In today's class, we will start with exercise 3.5. Exercise 3.5, what they have told, subtract the first one from the second one. From means what? The second polynomial should be written first. Okay, the second polynomial should be written first. So, we will start the sum. The second polynomial is 5y square into this thing. Okay, so 5y square into x square y cube minus 2x power 4y plus 10x square minus of this thing. So you remove the bracket, you will get 5x square y power 5. Okay, see y square plus y cube. So add the powers, okay. Bases are same, what you will do for multiplication? You will add the powers. So this will be 5x square y power 5 minus 5 into 2 is 10, 10 x power 4 and y square plus into y will give you y cube. So minus 10 x power 4 y cube plus 5 into 10 is 50, 50 y square x square minus, now inside this bracket you have minus 2 x square y square and here you have y cube plus 7 x square y plus 5. First I have multiplied this thing, that's all. Okay, minus 2 x square y square and then next step only I will multiply the inside things. So this this fully write as it is. Okay, outside the bracket fully as it is you copy. So 5 x square y power 5 minus 10 x power 4 y cube plus 50 y square x square minus of bracket. This will give you minus, see, minus into plus is minus, minus 2 x square y power 5, minus into plus again is minus, 2 sevens are 14, 14 x power 4 y cube, minus into plus is minus, 2 into 5 is 10, 10 x square y square. This is what will happen inside the bracket. And now again you have to remove this bracket. Minus into minus is plus, like that remove the bracket. So here you will get 5 x square y power 5 minus 10 x power 4 y cube plus 50 y square x square minus into minus is plus plus 2 x square y power 5 again minus into minus is plus 14 x power 4 y power y cube again minus into minus is plus minus into this one is plus, so 10 x square y square. Now what you have to do, if any like terms are there, you group that. So this will be 5 x square y power 5 plus 2 x square y power 5 minus 10 x power 4 y cube plus 14 x power 4 y cube plus this thing. Okay, all the like terms you group together. So here you will get 5 plus 2 is 7, 7 x square y power 5. And minus 10 plus 14 will give you plus 4. 4 x power 4 y cube plus 50 plus 10 is 60. Plus 60 x square y square. So this is the final answer. Okay. So subtract the this from this means what? Second polynomial minus the first one. Now you have the second one. Second one what they have told? Multiply. Okay, that is you have to multiply a binomial with a binomial. Two terms, here also two terms. Okay, multiplication of binomial with the binomial. You have to use a distributive property and multiply. Now when you are multiplying, see, first with 4x square you have to multiply 3x and 4x square you have to multiply minus 2. So what you will get? 4 into 3 is 12, x square into x is x cube. 12x cube minus 4 into 2 is 8, 8x square and then with 9 you have to multiply 3x and with 9 you have to multiply minus 2. So 9 into 3 is 27, 27x plus into minus is minus, minus 18. Okay, now do you have any like terms here? All the terms are unlike terms. You can't group anything. So this is your final answer. Okay, so we have used a distributive property and we have multiplied both the binomials. Now the next one, third one you have, find the simple interest on rupees 5a square b square. Okay, We have learned last year the simple interest formula is PNR by 100. So what is your phi a square b square? Your phi a square b square is the principal for 4AB years. That is number of years. N is given as 4AB at 7B% per annum. That is the rate of interest. R is given as 7B%. Okay. So we will use the formula PNR by 100. And we will see what answer you are getting. So first write the simple interest formula. Simple interest equals PNR by 100. So P is given as 5 A square B square. Number of years N is given as 4AB. And R is given as 7B. Divided by 100. Okay. So cancel this from the numerator. 5 into 4 is 20. 20 how many times is 100? 5 times is 100. Okay, cancel like this, or you can cancel with 5 table and then with 4 table. So you will get 7 by 5. Now see, here you have a square, here you have a. So a square into a will give you a cube. Then this is b square, and here also b into b is there. That will again give you b square. So b square into b square will give you b power 4. So the final answer for this is 7 by 5. A cube B power 4. Okay. 7 by 5 A cube B power 4. That is the simple interest. Okay. That much rupees. And box the answer. Now the fourth one you have. Fourth one what they have told. The cost of a notebook is rupees 10 AB. If Babu has rupees 5 a square b plus 20 a b square plus 40 a b, then how many notebooks he can buy? Okay. So one notebook costs how much? 10 a b. Okay. And this much amount he is having, with this much amount, how many notebooks he can buy? So the fourth one is here. Okay. This is the fourth one and this is the fifth one. Okay, first we will do the fourth one. So your fourth one, for rupees 10 AB, number of notebooks he can buy is 1. Okay, for rupees 10 AB, number of notebooks he can buy is 1. Then for rupees 5 A square B plus 20 AB square plus 40 AB, number of notebooks he can buy is total amount divided by cost of one notebook. Okay. There is a total amount and one notebook cost is 10 AB. So 5 A square B plus 20 AB square plus 40 AB whole divided by 10 AB. So what you will do? Divide each term by 10 AB. So 5 A square B by 10 AB plus 20 AB square by 10 AB plus 40 AB divided by 10 AB. Now when you are dividing with the same base, what you will do? You will subtract the powers, right? So this will be 5, 2 times is 10. So 1 by 2, A power 2 minus 1, B power 1 minus 1. Okay. This, see the denominator power of A is 1. That 1 when it goes up it becomes minus. So this will be A power 2 minus 1 and B power 1 minus 1. Plus 10, how many times is 20? 2 times is 20. So this is 2. A power 1 minus 1, B power 2 minus 1. Okay, plus 10, 4 times is 40, 4 A power 1 minus 1, B power 1 minus 1. Now here you have 1 by 2 A, B power 1 minus 1 is 0. So half A, B power 0 plus 2 A power 0, B power 1. Plus 4, A power 0, B power 0. Now you all know, anything power 0 is 1. Okay, anything power 0 is 1. So here you will get half of A plus 2B plus 4. Because A power 0 also is 1, B power 0 also is 1. If you don't want to use the rules of exponents, you can just cancel this B and B cancel, this A and A cancel. That way also you can cancel into. Okay. So final answer will be half A or A by 2. Okay. A by 2 plus 2B plus 4. So this is how you will do the fourth one. That is, this much notebooks he can buy. Okay, for rupees 5 a square b plus 20 a b square plus 40 a b. How many notebooks he can buy? A by 2 plus 2 b plus 4. This much notebooks he can buy. So this completes your fourth one. Now next you have the fifth one. Fifth one, what they have told? Factorize 7y square minus 19y minus 6. 7y square minus 19y minus 6. So here we have, now see, this type of sums, what you will do? You have to use the factor tree method. When you multiply, what you should get? When you multiply, you should get the last two terms. That is, 6 into minus 6 into 7 is minus 42y square. Okay, when you multiply, you should get minus 42y square. When you add, how much you should get? Minus 19y. Okay. So, what you have to do? You have to see all the factors of 42. Okay, 7, 6 are 42. You have one factor. 42, 1s are 42. You have another factor. Then 21 into 2 also is 42. Okay, 21 into 2 also is 42. Now what's the middle symbol here? Middle symbol here is minus. So the bigger number has to be negative. So this is minus 21y into 2y. Okay, minus 21y into 2y will give you minus 42. Then minus 21 plus 2 will give you minus 19y. So you will split this minus 19 as minus 21 plus 2. So here you will get y square minus 21y plus 2y minus 6. So 7y is common here, y minus 3 plus 2 is common here, y minus 3. So you will get y minus 3 common here, y minus 3 and y 7y plus 2. So when you factorize this, you will get y minus 3, 7y plus 2. So this completes your fifth one. Okay, this completes your fifth one. The next one what you have is the challenging problems. Okay, now the challenging problems, the first one you have, see properly. A contractor uses the expression 4x square plus 11x plus 6 to determine the amount of wire to order while wiring a house. If the expression comes from multiplying the number of rooms times the number of outlets. Okay, how many rooms are there and how many outlets are there? These two things you have to multiply. And he knows the number of rooms to be x plus 2. Okay, number of rooms into number of outlets equals 4x square plus 11x plus 6. This is what is given to you. Okay, and number of rooms they have given as x plus 2. So find the number of outlets in terms of x. So what you have to do? Whatever expression is given, that expression you have to factorize. Okay, with the help of factor tree, you need to factorize the expression. So, here what they have given? Sixth one, the number of rooms they have given as x plus 2. So, number of rooms into number of outlets equals amount of wire. Okay, so x plus 2 into number of outlets equals 4x square plus 11x plus 6. So number of outlets will be 4x square plus 11x plus 6 divided by x plus 2. Now you factorize this. When you multiply, what you should get? 6 into 4, 24. When you multiply, you should get 24x square. When you add, you should get 11x. So here you will write the factors. 8 into 3 is 24 and 8 plus 3 is 11. Okay. So this 4x square plus 11x plus 6, you will split it as 4x square plus 8x plus 3x plus 6. So 4x square plus 8x plus 3x plus 6. The first two terms, when you see, you have 4x common. So 4x into x plus 2 plus 3 times x plus 2. So x plus 2 into 4x plus 3. X plus 2 is common here. You will get 4x plus 3. So number of outlets will be 4x square plus 11x plus 6 divided by x plus 2. Now when you factorize the numerator, what we got? X plus 2 into 4x plus 3. So x plus 2 cancel, you will get 4x plus 3. Okay, so this is how you complete the sixth one. That is number of outlets, we got it as 4x plus 3. Now the next one, you have the seventh one. Seventh one, what they have told? A mason uses the expression x squared plus 6x plus 8 to represent the area of a floor of a room. Okay. If he decides that the length of the room will be represented as x plus 4. Now see, when a room is of the form length and breadth are given, that will be a rectangle. So you all know what's the length of a rectangle, yes? Length of a rectangle is L into B.